So welcome back everyone, Mike here. Kind of a rainy, dreary kind of day today. We did have some storms pass through, but I just checked the forecast. It looks pretty nice for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, which will be really good. But this evening, I just came down here to hook up to my trailer. I kind of need to use it on and off over the next couple days. Tonight, I'm going to pick up a toolbox that I bought off a real nice lady. I don't really need the trailer for it, but it's pretty heavy, so we won't have to lift it as high. Plus, I need the trailer tomorrow as well. But anyway, we're gonna go pick up that toolbox, come back here, may split a little bit of wood tonight, but really today's video, we're gonna talk about like side businesses, using YouTube as a business, and just kind of hustling to kind of get ahead. And so that's what we're gonna talk about when we get back. But anyway, I'm gonna hop in the truck right now, head over and get the new toolbox. I'll show you that, and we'll go from there. Okay, you think you can lift that up on there?
Yeah, sure.
By yourself?
No. I wouldn't be able to grab it.
All right. Daughter Hannah and I are gonna lift this on top. You ready, Hannah?
Yeah. I'm in.
Perfect. So here's a better look at the toolbox I just bought. It's a CSPS, which I've never heard of before. I kind of fell into this deal. I guess you could say Melissa was helping a friend the other day, and then they went to help another lady that lived down the road. Melissa met her, she's moving and down south with her daughter, and she was selling a bunch of stuff, so I bought this. But it's all stainless steel, pop open, there's 19 drawers total. Pretty nice. It's heavy, I know that. Same key works top and bottom. Yeah, should be good. But anyway, no wood split in the night. It's raining pretty steady right now, and I just checked the radar. Looks like it's gonna rain for at least another hour. But tomorrow is Thursday. That's when you'll see this video. Gotta work tomorrow, but then Friday we have the Bantam Jeep Invasion. Melissa and I will be up there. Weather looks great for it, and Saturday and Sunday. But anyway, what I wanted to talk about today, Daniel from Arms Family Homestead, he did a video the other day, and it made me think about this a little bit more. I've been wanting to do a video like this for a while. Daniel was talking about his YouTube channel and the income that he makes from it and side jobs and just how to hustle and how to kind of get ahead in life a little bit. And I really like Daniel. We talk quite often, actually, maybe every couple weeks or something like that. We'll have a phone call or text back and forth and share ideas and things like that. But Daniel was talking about his channel, you know, and the way things started for him. And I think it's kind of a similar story to how things started for us. I started this YouTube channel, I don't even know why, to tell you the truth. I just kind of started it as a hobby a little over 2 years ago, and it just kind of started growing. And I wasn't expecting it at first, and it was kind of weird. I uploaded a video, and you know, it got 50 views or 80 views, and then you check back a month later or something, it had 1,000 and then 8,000 views, and so then I uploaded another video. And at first, I didn't like talking in front of a camera, which I'm really not a huge fan of it even yet after 460 videos. I like doing videos where I'm doing stuff, you know what I mean? Not just standing in front of a camera and talking, but I'm getting more accustomed to it and it's getting easier. But anyway, I'm getting off topic. So my channel kind of started growing, and then after a while, you know, it became monetized where I would get paid from YouTube. And at first it wasn't very much money at all, and then but it kept growing. And so what happened is this hobby that I started, it actually turned into something, and things have been going really well with everything, with the channel. Views have been through the roof, and I owe a huge thanks to all of you for that. And it made me think, you know, this YouTube thing has just turned into another side gig, like I've always done. My whole life I've always done something on the side. I wouldn't say I never had a good job. I never had a cushy job, put it that way. You know, I always worked like heavy highway construction. I was a blaster. The first job I ever had where I actually got paid vacation was this job that I currently work now, and I started it about 8 years ago. You know, for years, you'd be in between jobs or whatever, that was pretty much your vacation. You didn't get paid, but I was always hustling. I always did something. And it was the only way we ever really managed to get ahead. Things were really lean there when we first got married, and we started having kids early, and Hunter, our oldest son with autism, that was really tough back then. And you know, I was working out a ton, Melissa's trying to take care of all the kids, and it was rough, it really was. But we just kept plugging away at everything. And you know, I'd work on a job 5-6 days a week, and then on the evenings and weekends, I was always doing something. I was clearing trees for people. I'd rent a machine and, you know, knock down a bunch of dead ash trees and burn them all up. But years ago, one of my sisters, she wanted a deck built. And we were in between two big projects at work, and I had about a week off. And I said, yeah, I'll build you a deck, you know what I mean? And I had maybe helped on one before, built one before. So I built her this big deck. Took longer than I thought it would. I did it all myself, but it came out really nice. I built some like built-in benches and things like that. Well, here's how things work. I built her this deck, came out really nice, and then she had a big party at her house, and she worked at a hospital. All her friends come out from the hospital, doctors, nurses, all that, and they're kind of admiring this new deck. Who built this deck? My brother did. Next thing you know, I'm like in the deck building business, and I always kind of like working by myself, though. Never really enjoyed hiring people. Or, you know, I just don't like that. I don't. I like doing things by myself. And so in between jobs, evenings, weekends, whatever, I must have built 30 or 40 decks. Play systems, like you see that one behind me. You've seen it in other videos that I built for our kids. Same thing. I built one for our kids. Next thing you know, a guy down the street wants one. Someone else wants one. So the point of all this is I have always done something on the side. I needed to survive. I really did. And it hadn't been until maybe 10 years ago where things start getting pretty good for us. You know, not great, we're not rich or anything like that by any means, but we're at a point in our lives now where if we want to take a vacation, we take a vacation. And it's been really, really good. And YouTube has really helped with that. I never in a million years expected to, you know, make money putting these videos up. And it bothers a lot of people. You know, a lot of people, oh, you get free stuff, you get this, and you know, you got an ad and ads in your video and all that. Of course you do. The thing about YouTube is that I don't think a lot of people understand. If it wasn't for money, there would be no YouTube. And I'm not saying that just for the creators wouldn't do it without money. It is huge. I mean, I see how clogged up my computer gets just, you know, 5-10 videos on it. I run everything on external hard drives, and there is 72 years worth of video uploaded to YouTube every single day. I mean, this is a massive, massive company, and billions of dollars are coming into it and going out of it. And if it wasn't for money, there'd be no YouTube. I mean, when I started out, I used my phone. Nothing wrong with that. If you want to start a channel, phone works great. But over time, you know, you want to try to make better videos, get some better gear. Heck, now I probably got $5,000-$6,000 worth of camera equipment. And you need that money to help buy that stuff to kind of keep growing the channel, and it just snowballs. And I never would have expected it. I keep repeating myself, but it's just blown away. I mean, we're getting anywhere from 1.5 million to 2.5 million views a month here the last couple months. And there's some really super great people, and we're just having a blast doing it. And it's so much fun. And the thing about what I like most about it is I'm working for myself, and it's not really work. If I get up in the morning, you know, I go to work all day. If I come home and I don't want to make a video, I don't make a video. But I've been really cranking them out just because I enjoy doing it. And like tomorrow night we're having this, or Friday night, we're having this meetup. We've had several last year, and we have really met some really nice people. We really have, and it's been a lot of fun. And but back to Daniel, you know, he was talking about hustling and trying to get ahead and side jobs and things like that. And I was curious, you know, how many of you out there do something on the side? You know, there's just countless opportunities right now out there. There really is. I'm not going to get political or anything like that, but I'm telling you right now, you know, for years, all I ever heard was, you know anybody hiring, you know anybody hiring. Now all I hear is, you know anybody that wants a job. And it is. There's a lot of opportunity, at least in our area right here. I can't speak for the whole country, but there's a lot of opportunity. And I think it's a great opportunity. You know, if you have a job with the benefits and the vacation like I do now, it's the perfect time to start something on the side and see what it turns into. And I don't mean just a YouTube channel. It could be anything. I learned a long time ago, people will pay you for two different things. They'll pay you to do things that they can't do or don't want to do. And that's just a fact of life. And I have made money over the years, lots of money, you know, worked my butt off, but someone will pay you to do something. And I don't care if you're pressure washing, if you're detailing cars, anything, videoing weddings. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. Reminds me of a story. I know a guy. And we were golfing one time. I used to golf quite a bit, and then once I really got into working around the property here, I gave up golf. I'd rather be on a tractor any day. But anyway, we're out golfing, and this guy that I know, he's a carpenter, really good carpenter, and he works for somebody else. And he had gotten divorced, and you know, he's always complaining he didn't have any money. I don't have any money. But he's out golfing and drinking beer. But I said to him, I said, hey, I got some stuff. You know, if you want to work in my place, I got a ton of stuff I can do. And my mother, she's got a bunch of stuff too, if you're interested. And he said, you know what? When I do that stuff all day, he goes, the last thing I want to do is pick up a hammer. And I just said, okay, you know, and that's totally cool if that's all you want to do. But, you know, 2 minutes ago, he's complaining he doesn't have enough money, and there's opportunities everywhere. There really is. So I was curious, like I said, what do you guys do for side work? I met a guy the other day. He's a subscriber to our channel, works in HR, super nice guy. Met him at Phantom Fireworks the other day, and we talked for a little bit. You know, he works in an office on the weekends. He's out hustling, doing other things, and making a few bucks on the side. I love that kind of stuff. I do. Anybody that just puts in the work, you know, I want everybody to do well. Some people, you know, it bothers them when they see somebody else that, that you know, they think they're doing really well. It bothers them. I'm thrilled. I am. That's the honest to goodness truth. I want to see everybody do well. And believe me, we have had some tough times over the years. We really have. When we first got married, things were rough. People see this channel today and like, oh, you got all this stuff given to you and a new truck and all that. It wasn't always like that at all, believe me. But we always just stayed focused. You know what I mean? You don't give up. You just keep pushing forward. And I really lucked into this YouTube thing. I had no idea that it would work out like it did. We're having a blast doing it, and we thank all of you guys from the bottom of our hearts. I mean, it's been great. It really has. And just the whole thing, you know what I mean? And it's a great setup. It really is. I got property. I like working outside. I partner with companies. You know, it gets their products out in front of you. I never sit here and say, you need to buy this. I couldn't care less what you buy. It doesn't matter one bit to me. Point is, if somebody's really interested in something, they can search YouTube for, you know, steel MS-462, and they can see me out there running it. They can say, you know, Google or search for RK-37, and they're going to see me out there picking up logs with that thing that are way more than you should be picking up. You're never going to see that stuff in a commercial or anything like that. Here, you just see what we do. Some things I do right, some things I don't do right. But I think the whole thing, the way it all works, is just, it's fascinating to me, and I really enjoy it, and I'm really thankful once again for all you guys for supporting us. Daniel also mentioned in his video the other day, people ask him all the time, when are you going to quit your job? When are you going to quit your job? I have no plans at all of quitting my job, not at all. I am nowhere near that point where I do that to make YouTube videos. But the biggest reason is not just financially. I mean, I've got all my benefits at work, a 401k. It's just a really good job. I like everybody that I work with. But more importantly is I don't want to turn this channel into a job. And what I'm saying is, you know, if I want to go make a video cutting firewood, that's what I'm going to do. If I just make videos on what I do around here. Nobody ever tells me, you know, you have to make a video on this or do this. I don't want to work for anybody else. And I don't want to get into a position where, you know, I got to make a video to pay bills. I'm not going to do that at all. That's not, that doesn't sound like any fun to me. That would turn this whole thing into a job that I probably would not like, is what that would do. And right now though, I'm getting some additional income for our family. It's really helped us out a bunch. And but we are working hard, you know, we really are. You see the amount of videos we're cranking out. I'll tell you a typical day here. I go to work, and like this morning, I left the house at 5:45 this morning, got home around 5, came home, went and got this toolbox, shot this little video here, which I normally don't do videos like this. Usually it's a little bit more elaborate and you're doing something, but I shot this video here, and I'll go in and get a bite to eat for dinner here in a little bit. I'll start editing this video, and usually around 9:30, 10 o'clock at night, I'm about had it. I'm about done, because I get up about 4:30 every day. And so I'll download everything tonight, kind of start editing the video. When I get tired, I'll be like, that's it, I'll go to bed. Tomorrow morning at 4:30, I'll finish editing this video. I'll blow through a bunch of comments. I love all the comments that you guys send. And, you know, answer as many as we can. Melissa does that all day long, that, Facebook, Gmail, all that. But anyway, I'll set the video up to publish tomorrow afternoon sometime at work. And then when I come home tomorrow night, I'll start the thing all over again. And that's what we do. And it's paying off. It is, because one, we're enjoying it. Two, we're making extra money for sure. And three, it's just great. It really is. So that's a typical day. You know, whenever you see a tractor here that someone's loaning me, or my partnership with Steel, there is nothing free. I'm telling you that right now. You have to really put in the work. And it's kind of like anything I've ever done. If I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it. You know what I mean? I mean, there's a lot of times I'll just sit in the couch and say, I'm not doing that. But if I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it to the best of my ability. And that's what I've tried to do with this channel. And I mean, we have stepped on the throttle. It's paying off. We're meeting more people. There's tons of views. It's just been great. It really has. And I'm not going to let up. That's the plan. I want to get to 100,000 subscribers. I have no idea why. It doesn't matter one bit how many subscribers you have. What matters is the views. That's how many people are watching your channel. We get lots of views. Subscribers, it goes up and down, dips. You know what I mean? We've gained every day. But I want to get to 100,000. Just a goal that I have in my head, no idea why. And I really don't care if it goes much beyond 100,000. And there's a couple reasons for that. One of the biggest reasons is if you see the real big channels, you know, like Wrangler Star, you know, he's great. He is. He has been doing this, I mean, putting in the work for years at this, and it has paid off for him. He is like 1.2 million subscribers or something like that. But when you get that big, there is no way that you can keep up with all the comments. And even though we don't respond to everything, I read all the comments, or Melissa does. I even have the kids reading the comments, and you know, they'll help me out. Hey, you need to get back to this guy, or call, you know, email this guy. And we all kind of work together. But once it gets really big, it's hard to kind of, you know, communicate with everybody and to answer everybody. And you see some of the real big channels. The Wrangler Star does a pretty good job though answering comments, but there's other ones, you know, I don't even think they ever look at the comments. You know what I mean? They just publish a video, watch the views go up, and do another video. And I don't want to turn that into this. It would just turn this into like a total job, and it'd lose the personal touch, I guess you could say. I don't know. But that's one of the reasons. 100,000 is the number that I'm after. After that, I really don't care. I'll tell you that right now. But we'll see what happens. We'll get there before the end of the year. I think we will. I really do. And that's a pretty bold statement, because I need like 30,000 or 28,000 more subscribers. But I think we'll get there. I don't know. We got a rainbow up there in the sky. Maybe we'll split a little wood before it gets dark. Sun's trying to peek through again. It's like almost 8 o'clock right now. But anyway, I've been rambling on long enough, and like I said earlier, videos like this I don't do very often. Usually I do videos where I'm actually out doing something. I still don't feel entirely comfortable just standing here talking in front of a camera. I feel like I should be doing something. But I may do this more often, maybe once a month or something like that when I have a topic that I want to talk about. What reminded me of this one, though, was Daniel's video from Arms Family Homestead. And some key points that I want to drive home here. I think it's a great time to start some type of side business. If you're in, you know, if you're interested in doing that, you need some extra money. You maybe want to eventually get out of your real job into something else. And always remember, people will pay you to do things that they can't do or don't want to do. They always have and they always will. And I've done a lot of that over the years. Always done something on the side. You know, maybe you want to start a YouTube channel. The thing about a YouTube channel is it's like anything else. You have to put in the work. I am basically working two full-time jobs right now. It's paying off, things are great, and I enjoy doing it, so I'm not complaining a bit. But I spend probably 40 hours a week between editing, comments, shooting videos, but what's nice about what I do, I'm getting stuff done. And it does take longer, you know, to accomplish what you're doing, setting up all the cameras, but I have found that it motivates me as well. A lot of people in the comments say, hey man, you're motivating me to get out and cut some wood or do this or do that. You guys motivate me as well. And so some nights, you know, I'll think, man, I should go do this. I don't know. And I'm like, well, I'll make a video of it too. And I'll go knock something out. And so you guys are motivating me. The whole thing's just working great, if you ask me. I'm loving it. I really am. So, but I think that's about it for today's video. Like I said, let me know in the comments what you do on the side. And if you're thinking about something, what you may do. But it's a tough world out there, but I still feel confident. If you put in the work, it will pay off eventually. It will. Oh, and one more thing. No matter what you're doing, don't try swinging for the fence every time at the plate. You know what I mean? You'll strike out more often than not. Just steady, slow growth. And that's what I've always done. And you know, you may be sitting here and saying, well, this guy's doing this much work. I'm here. I'm telling you, consistency is where it's at. That's my opinion. That has always worked well for me. Even like with this channel, we've never had, you know, viral videos or anything like that. It's just been consistent growth. New people coming in every day, nice, normal, new people, all like-minded like us, but don't swing for the fence. You know, if you're gonna go start a grass cutting business, I wouldn't go try to pick up some ginormous commercial account for your first one. Baby steps, you know what I mean? And just keep building. And but don't swing for the fence. My opinion only, but that has worked for me over the years. But I think that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. Click subscribe and share with your friends. Thanks.